The Minnesota Department of Revenue's e-services system allows Minnesota businesses to file and pay their taxes online. You can use e-services to communicate with the department and view account information for your state taxes. Whether you're using a computer, smartphone, or tablet, e-services works on all your devices. You can access e-services from our website's homepage by selecting Login to e-services under Top Tasks. To log in, you'll need your username and password. If you're new to e-services, you'll need to create an account by selecting Create a Username. To create your e-services account, you'll need your Minnesota tax ID number. You'll also need the temporary password sent during the business tax registration process. If you forget your login information, you can select Forgot Username or Password. To reset your password, you'll need a username. If you forget your username, you'll need the email address you used to create your account. After entering your username and password, you'll need to complete two-step verification using your phone number or email address. If you select the box labeled Trust This Device, you won't need to enter a verification code again unless you log in on a new device, switch browsers, or delete your browser cookies. Once you've logged in, Accounts will display your tax accounts. From here, you can view your balances. To make a payment, select Make a Payment. To begin filing a return, select Returns and Periods. If you have three or more tax accounts, selecting Favorites will let you save your favorite accounts. Alerts shows items requiring your attention. For example, you'll receive an alert if a return is past due or if there's a tax rate change that impacts your accounts. To update your information, select Manage My Profile or the View Profile icon at the top of any page. Here, you can manage and update business contact information and two-step verification settings. You can view profile-related alerts, update banking information, and manage who has access to your accounts. If you have questions while using e-services, select the Help icon at the top of any page. Once you begin a return, you'll be prompted to import or manually enter your data. If you select the Import option, be sure to use one of the file formats listed on our site. If you use Enter Your Data, the system will walk you through each step. If you need to pause, use the Save and Finish Later feature, which saves your return data for 14 days. Remember, your return isn't submitted until completed. If your session expires, you'll need to re-enter your information. In the next section, you'll enter your gross receipts. Gross receipts are the total sales from all business operations in Minnesota during the reporting period. They include all taxable and exempt sales, leases, and rentals. They don't include sales tax, cannabis tax, or any other taxes or fees. When completing this section, do not subtract any costs or expenses. Below the gross receipts section is the Enter Taxable Sales and Purchases section. You'll need to complete the applicable fields in the Amount column to determine your tax liability. As you complete these fields, the Tax Due column will automatically populate with the appropriate amount. If you have taxable cannabis sales or cannabis purchases subject to use tax, you'll enter those in this section. Minnesota use tax applies when you buy, lease, or rent taxable items or services for your business, and the seller does not charge Minnesota sales tax. For variable rate purchases, you'll need to complete both the amount field and the tax due field. E-services doesn't automatically calculate tax liability for variable rate purchases because rates vary by location, such as Wisconsin, Iowa, or the Dakotas. If you have multiple Minnesota locations where sales and purchases occur, you may need to report different taxable amounts for local taxes. To do this, select the blank row at the bottom of the table. Start typing the local tax name and select it from the list. This local tax line will appear on future sales and use tax returns. If you don't need to report a local tax that you're registered for, leave that line blank. Deleting a tax line by selecting the X removes it from that specific return, but it will remain on your account for future returns. Click Next to review the return summary. If the information is correct, select Next for payment options. If the information is incorrect, select Previous to go back and make changes. On the Payment Options screen, you can enter your bank information and save it for future payments. To confirm the payment amount, you'll need to type it in manually. If needed, you can change the payment date to a future date. If you don't have bank information to enter, select No and continue filing the return. However, you'll need to make the payment by the due date to avoid interest and penalties. Click Next to confirm your entries and proceed to the Submission Summary screen. Once you verify the projected amount due and payment information, you can submit your return. To submit the return and payment, select Submit. After submission, you'll see a confirmation summary where you can access your filing history or print or email your return. If you select Print Return, be aware that a pop-up blocker may prevent the print window from appearing. When you're done with the confirmation page, select OK. For more information on e-services, visit revenue.state.mn.us and search for e-services.